Hello, my name is Xin Xu, the director of NCATS Drug Metabolism and Pharmacokinetics Core, or DMPK Core in short. In this virtual lab tour, we'll walk through our wet lab facility and meet with our scientists. Before that, let me introduce Jacob. He will guide us through this tour.
Hi, my name is Jacob Schimitz, and I'm a postdoc with the NCATS DMPK group.
To begin our tour, the DMPK lab was established back in 2011 with the mission to accelerate translational research by rapid selection and advancement of drug candidates with appropriate ADME and PK properties. Our main research focus is on the development of translational ADME and PK tools to accelerate drug discovery and development projects for unmet medical needs. As shown in this slide, DMPK is a key component in translational research from probe development to clinical trials. To bridge the gap between drug discovery and human clinical trials, DMPK Lab is built with the capability to support a project from an early exploratory stage with high-throughput screening Tier 1 ADME assays and all other stages of drug discovery and development up to clinical trials. Our lab capabilities are built accordingly. Now, let's visit our lab and meet with our scientists. Welcome to the DMPK Lab. Our facilities are composed of four main sections: the wet lab, the mass spec lab, the tissue culture lab, and the animal facility. Let's start with the wet lab first, where our Tier 1 ADME assays are conducted. Tier 1 ADME assays are developed to support early stage projects. We support chemists in the TDB, ETB, APP, and chemistry technology branches who work on a wide variety of drug discovery projects here at NCATS, and they're synthesizing new compounds for these projects every week. These compounds are first purified and registered with NCATS compound management. Once registered, these compounds make it to the in vitro ADME group for testing in three important ADME assays, including kinetic aqueous solubility, PAMPA permeability, and rat liver microsomal stability. These constitute the Tier 1 suite of ADME assays. To run our high-throughput Tier 1 ADME assays, we are equipped with two TCAN automated liquid handler workstations. These Tier 1 data offer essential information regarding basic ADME properties to help project teams optimize their compounds and prioritize or advance compounds further into Tier 2 studies. Compounds that show a reasonable balance of ADME properties, along with potency and other parameters, move further along in the drug discovery process. For advanced projects, we run several Tier 2 assays, including, but not limited to, multipoint, multi-species microsome and cytosol stability, plasma protein binding, PAMPA BBB, plasma stability assays, and CYP450 inhibition assays. We are equipped with two units of Q-exactive Orbitrap systems that analyze drug concentrations in various matrices. Since all our work is high throughput, analyzing LC-MS data can be very laborious and time-consuming, especially with our multipoint microsome and cytosol stability experiments, where more than 1,150 LC-MS files need to be processed and then analyzed. To resolve this issue, we worked extensively with our bioinformatics experts, who helped us build tools to optimize and automate not only the data processing, but also the data analysis. Most of these tools have been made available to the public, and we know of at least two biotech companies who have gone on and implemented these tools in their own drug discovery endeavors. The codes have been downloaded multiple times, so we are sure there are many others who have benefited from our efforts, which is highly encouraging. The cost of bringing a new drug candidate from discovery into the market has risen steadily during the past few decades and currently stands around $2.6 billion. Any advances that accelerate this process and/or lower costs are extremely beneficial. With the advent of machine learning techniques, in silico models for the prediction of ADME properties have risen in popularity and are routinely employed by pharmaceutical companies. Using our high-quality, large datasets, we have generated predictive models for 11 ADME endpoints. The prediction results can be used to rank order compounds for synthesis, and thus, project teams can get their lead compounds in fewer iterations, saving money and resources, but more importantly, accelerating the process. We have made these models publicly available on the Open Portal ADME website to benefit and accelerate drug discovery across all research groups. Other Tier 2 assays include metabolite identification to illustrate metabolic soft spots of a molecule, and cell-based assays to assess permeability and efflux. In metabolite identification, or MET-ID studies, we incubate a test compound with liver microsomes or cytosols. We can run the study manually or use the TCAM platform to process a batch of compounds. MetID is a technique to elucidate the fate of a compound after being metabolized by liver enzymes such as CYP450s. Information gained from MetID studies can guide chemists in optimizing their compounds. Comparing metabolic profiles across species can help to choose appropriate animal species that most resemble human metabolite exposure for toxicity studies. For MetID studies, we use a Synapt G2-Si QTOF mass spec system. During sample analysis, we can separate metabolites from parent molecules and analyze their fragmentation profiles. This allows us to delimit portions of the molecule that may have been modified by metabolizing enzymes. We also utilize software to help us in the metabolite structure identification, such as metabolinks from waters and MassMetaCyte from molecular discovery. The latter also helps us perform automated MetID, which is useful for processing batches of compounds. The cell culture lab is where we conduct cell-based studies for Tier 2 assays. We routinely run KCO2 and MDCK-MDR1 cell-based assays to assess passive permeability and efflux transport, which is very important in determining the fate of the compound in the body. Cells are cultured in 96-well transwell plates, and these assays for discovery compounds are also performed using the automated TCAN platform. To ensure the formation of monolayers of cells on the donor side of the transwell, a special device is used to measure the transepithelial electrical resistance, or TEER for short. Working with applied biophysics, we have developed the automated TEER 96 measurement device. This device reads the resistance of each of these 96 wells in less than 2 minutes and stores the data electronically. The device can also read TEER continuously to assess barrier function and integrity over time. Compounds that show good in vitro ADME properties and other characteristics are selected as development candidates. The top lead candidate will be further studied for IND filing. To support an IND filing, we will conduct a series of IND-enabling ADME and PK studies. We also conduct PK simulation and provide prediction of human PK prior to clinical trials. The in-life portion of PK studies in rodents is conducted at the animal facility located at the NIH main campus with help from the Division of Veterinary Resources. More information can be found on the NIH DVR website. Additional PK studies, especially PK in large animals, are conducted at CRO labs. The PK samples are shipped to our lab for quantitative analysis. Plasma and tissue samples, such as brain, liver, kidney, and lung, collected from PK studies are prepared for bioanalysis in the wet lab. We use the tissue homogenizer to homogenize tissue samples in 48 well plates. Plasma and tissue homogenate samples are then prepared by protein precipitation in 96 well plates for analysis. The biomech liquid handler is used to transfer supernatant. We use control blank biological matrices for calibration standards and quality control samples to quantify PK samples. Drug concentrations and samples are analyzed by UPLC-MSMS. We have two UPLC-MSMS instruments, one being Waters Zevo TQS and the other is a SciEx API 7500. We optimize UPLC and MSMS conditions to improve the sensitivity and selectivity of the assays. We usually analyze 3 to 4 plates overnight under controlled temperature. The sensitive and robust UPLC-MSMS methods ensure the accurate quantitation of compounds in the PK samples. The UPLC-MSMS methods are transferred to CROs for GLP toxicokinetic studies when the compounds have advanced to the late stages of preclinical drug development. We also have assays developed for humans to support clinical trials. We use Farsight Winnelin software to calculate PK parameters of the compound in plasma and tissues. These PK parameters allow for the evaluation of the compound ADME properties in vivo. These PK data are critical in understanding the compound ADME properties in different animal species and in predicting human PK parameters. For many projects, the therapeutics being developed are biologics, such as peptides, proteins, antibodies, oligonucleotides, or gene therapies. For these molecules, we are primarily concerned with developing the analytical assays needed to measure PK properties in vivo or immunogenicity characteristics of these therapies. Since these molecules are larger, more delicate structurally, and often present at very low concentrations in vivo, particularly sensitive assays such as immunoassays, qPCR, and partial enrichment via magnetic bead technology are often critical to success. We also have the capability to develop world-class LC-MS assays for larger molecules in conjunction with immunocapture. The DMPK group has the instrumentation and expertise to develop an array of assay types, including ELISAs, multiplex, Western blots, and cell-based assays, which are generally transferred to CRO partners for validation and execution in a regulated environment. We participate in the bioanalytical planning of animal studies necessary to file a new drug application for a biological molecule, working closely with regulated organizations and collaborators to plan and execute the studies with full FDA compliance. Since specific high-affinity antibodies are often crucial to the mission, we have close relationships with custom antibody development companies and have raised custom monoclonal antibodies for a variety of projects. We provide support for human PK study design and assay development. Over the years, we have collected many ADME and PK parameters from the most promising molecules that may become IND candidates and possibly patient therapies. Using these datasets, we can gain a deeper understanding into the behavior of compounds in humans. Using in vitro metabolism, permeability, protein binding, transporter efflux, and other data from preclinical studies, we can build physiology-based pharmacokinetic models. Once these models are able to confidently predict PK profiles in multiple animal species, we can extrapolate the knowledge to a human organism. With that, we gain more confidence in predicting dosing regimen design for clinical trials. In summary, the DMPK core is a very productive research unit at NCATS DPI, with solid scientific knowledge, high enthusiasm and energy for research, and dedicated resources, our scientists have successfully supported all stages of projects across NCATS drug discovery and development. Our study results have been published in journals as well as submitted for regulatory filings. We would like to acknowledge our collaborators and trainees for their great contribution to our success. As we continue to build a strong research team, we welcome more young scientists to join us in the exciting and challenging journey that is translational research. Thanks for watching.